Hi friends, it's Rex, and today we're going to read about The Velociraptor by Janet Riehecky. It's a little explorer's book. Very cool. Here is a look at the table of contents and everything we're going to be learning about today in this book. Dinophile. Name, Velociraptor. How to say it, Velociraptor. When it lived, in the Cretaceous period and the Mesozoic era. What it ate, meat. Size, 5 to 6 feet long, almost 3 feet tall, and weighed 30 to 40 pounds. The Velociraptor lived 75 million to 71 million years ago. The fierce meat eater was smaller than many other dinosaurs during the time. Thanks to fossils. A fossil is evidence of life from the past. Fossils of things like bones, teeth, and tracks found in the earth have taught us everything we know about dinosaurs. A large bird. Long, stiff tail. Velociraptor was about as tall as a Great Dane, but it was much slimmer. A sickle claw on each foot. Flat, long head. Sharp teeth. 3 fingers on each hand. Feathers on arms and body. If animals like Velociraptor were alive today, our first impression would be that they were just very unusual looking bird. This is from paleontologist Mark Norell. The Raptor Group. Velociraptor was part of a group of dinosaurs called the Raptors. The Raptor Group had many other dinosaurs in it. The Oviraptor was about the same size as a Velociraptor. Its skeleton was found in a nest of dinosaur eggs, so scientists named it Egg Thief. Later, scientists discovered the eggs belonged to the Oviraptor. Deinonychus lived in packs and hunted small and even large dinosaurs. Deinonychus was about the size of a mountain lion. The Achillobator was bigger than a Deinonychus, and it grew to almost 20 feet long and weighed 500 to 1,000 pounds. The Utah Raptor is the biggest raptor discovered so far. It grew to about 23 feet long and weighed almost 1 ton. Its sickle claw was 12 inches long. Utah Raptor was named after Utah, the state where it was found. Feathers. Scientists discovered quill knobs on Velociraptor's arm in 2007. Quill knobs proved the dinosaur had feathers. Male Velociraptors may have had brightly colored feathers. Bright feathers helped attract a mate. Female Velociraptors likely had dull feathers. Females could spread their feathers over their eggs. These feathers hid the eggs from sunlight and predators. Velociraptor's feathers didn't help it fly. Its arms were too short and its body was too long to get off the ground. Some birds today can't fly either, such as ostriches and penguins. Stiff tail. Velociraptor's tail was stiff and stuck straight out. It helped Velociraptor to keep its balance when walking or running. Dinosaurs such as the Diplodocus used their tails as weapons. They swung their tails like whips, but not Velociraptor. Its tail was too stiff to swing like that. When Velociraptor moved, its tail swung back and forth. The swinging tail helped the dinosaur change directions quickly when it ran. Velociraptors might have been able to do some amazing twists and turns to escape predators or to catch prey. Fast runner. Velociraptor's slim body and long legs may have made it a fast runner. Speed allowed Velociraptor to catch its next meal and escape hungry predators. Many scientists believe Velociraptor ran as fast as 24 miles an hour. Other scientists don't agree that the dinosaur was a fast runner. They think Velociraptor's long legs helped it climb and jump. Velociraptor's name means swift thief. sickle claw. Velociraptor had sharp claws on its hands and feet. The second toe of each foot had an especially large claw called a sickle claw. To keep the claw sharp, Velociraptors held it above the ground when it walked or ran. The sickle claw could break through skin and hold onto prey, but it wasn't strong enough or sharp enough to kill another dinosaur. Birds of prey, like hawks and eagles, also have a larger claw on their second toes. Hunting food. Velociraptor was a carnivore. Carnivores eat meat. This dinosaur was a good hunter. Its eyes faced forward, which gave it great eyesight. Sneaking up on prey was an easy task. When Velociraptor attacked, its large sickle claw helped hold on to its prey. Its razor-sharp teeth helped kill the animal. Velociraptors may have hunted in packs. Working together would have allowed them to attack larger prey. Because of its size, Velociraptor probably ate small dinosaurs, lizards, and insects. It may have also eaten the eggs of other dinosaurs. It is likely Velociraptor was also a scavenger. It would wait for a big predator to finish eating its kill. Then it could rush in to eat whatever was left. Velociraptor's home. Velociraptor lived during the Cretaceous period. It made its home in the desert areas of what is now Mongolia, China. Velociraptor's home was hot and dry. Water and plants could be found in only a few places. Sand stretched out across the land. Sometimes giant sand dunes formed. There were also volcanoes. Other Cretaceous animals: the Tyrannosaurus rex, the Triceratops, the Ankylosaurus, the Oviraptor, and the Protoceratops. The Cretaceous period lasted from 145 to 66 million years ago. It's called the Dinosaur Era. You can see the Triassic, the Jurassic, and the Cretaceous periods and how many millions of years ago they were. Growing up. Scientists haven't found many clues about what Velociraptor was like growing up. Other dinosaurs in the raptor group took care of their young. That probably means Velociraptor did too. Young Velociraptor had larger eyes and a shorter snout than adults. Here's an oviraptor with its eggs. Discovery. Paleontologist Roy Chapman Andrews discovered the first Velociraptor fossils. He found them in the Gobi Desert of Mongolia in the 1920s. Velociraptor bones have only been found in Mongolia, but other raptors have been found all around the world, including the United States. Andrews and his team found other dinosaurs as well, including the oviraptor. They also discovered the first dinosaur eggs. Forever in battle. Paleontologists made an amazing fossil find in the Gobi Desert in 1971. A Velociraptor and a Protoceratops were found locked in battle. Velociraptor was holding onto the Protoceratops' head. Its sickle claw was sunk into the dinosaur's chest. Protoceratops was biting Velociraptor's right arm, which was broken. They died in the middle of the fight. This was the first fossil discovery to show two dinosaurs fighting each other. As you can see here, the Protoceratops and the Velociraptor. That is awesome. Some scientists think the fighting dinosaurs died when a strong wind blew a sand dune on top of them. That's crazy. Did you know? A bone in Velociraptor's eye shows it might have been nocturnal. That means it hunted at night and slept during the day. This same bone is found today in nocturnal birds and lizards. The 1993 movie Jurassic Park made Velociraptor famous. But the movie's dinosaur did not look like Velociraptor. This dinosaur didn't have feathers. It was also much bigger and smarter than Velociraptor really was. The dinosaur in the movie was based on the body of a large Deinonychus. Like birds today, Velociraptor had hollow bones. It was also probably warm-blooded. Toronto, Canada's professional basketball team is named the Toronto Raptors. Alright, what a great book. Now here's a glossary with some terms that you may want to review yourself. And there's some good questions. So I'm going to ask you the questions. Let's see if you could answer them. Velociraptor was smaller than many dinosaurs, but still a fierce predator during the Cretaceous period. Describe two ways a Velociraptor caught its prey. Go on, you can answer that now. Here's the next question. Velociraptor was likely a nocturnal dinosaur. What does nocturnal mean? Name one modern animal that is nocturnal. Look at the image on page 26 and describe in your own words what is happening in this scene. All right, well, that was a great book about Velociraptors. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video, sign up for notifications, and tell a friend about Rex Reads. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.